All right, folks, I have finally got my hands on the Huawei Nova 7i. Now, this one has been around for a while, but I was a little late to get my hands on this one. Right on the front of the box, you can see the Huawei Nova 7i branding. The price of this phone for my region is also mentioned here. It's coming for about 43,999 rupees in my country. In the UK, it's coming for around 285 pounds. You can find the price for other regions on your screen. So here on the left side and on the right side, we have the Huawei Nova 7i branding once again. And at the top, we have the Huawei stamp. At the bottom of the box, we have some phone details. This one comes with an internal storage of 1 to 8 GB. It's got a RAM of 8 GB. And this phone's color is crush green. And then there is a model number written next to it. Now this phone is also being offered in the midnight black and the sakura pink color. Now without any further ado, let's get this phone out of its box now. And in my region, this phone is coming with a warranty of 1 year. And here is the Huawei Nova 7i out of its box in the crush green color. You can see how beautiful this phone is. Now I will just turn this phone on and put it on a side for a while. In the meanwhile, we will check the contents of the box. Alright, so here we are first of all getting this SIM eject tool for the Huawei Nova 7i. And we are getting some paperwork. If you are feeling like having a lot of free time, you can definitely give it a read. And we have this TPU case here. This is not a very high-end TPU case, but it's still going to protect your phone. Now here is the main highlight of the Huawei Nova 7i. I am talking about this 40 watts fast charging brick. It is actually the super fast charging brick and it's very heavy, I can tell you that right now. Now according to Huawei, this charger will charge your phone from 0 to 70% in about 30 minutes. Now the realistic results can be different and we will see that in our battery drain and charging test. We also get this USB type C cable. This is the USB type A to type C cable. And we also get this typical Huawei headphone in the box of the Huawei Nova 7i. Before I jump into the nitty gritty details of this phone, let me talk a little bit about its design and build. So this phone comes with Huawei's typical design language. At the back, you can see this camera cutout, which is a square cutout holding the four cameras. The one thing that I really liked about this phone is its build. Now, this phone is built out of plastic, but it does not feel like plastic. But we know that it's not glass in real, nor does it have a glass protection. The frame is also built out of plastic, but it's just painted in such a way that it complements the overall color and the build quality of the phone. This right here is the 6.4 inches IPS LCD display of this phone. It has a resolution of 1080 into 2310 pixels and it's got a PPI of 398. The screen to body ratio on this phone is 83.5, which is pretty good. And this is how the phone looks and feels with its TPU case. It's pretty much grippable. As far as the phone's buttons are concerned, this phone has got its fingerprint scanner and the power button on the right side. Next to that is the volume rocker of this phone. These are not very much tactile buttons, but they are pretty good. At the top, we have this phone's secondary noise cancellation mic. On the left side, we have the phone's SIM card slot. Let's check out what it has to offer. Alright, so in this SIM card, you can either put in two nano SIM cards or one nano SIM card and one SD card at the same time. At the bottom, you have the USB Type-C port in the middle, the primary mic of the phone, a bottom firing speaker grill, and the headphone jack. Now on the front, you can see that we have this punch hole towards the top left corner of the screen. This punch hole on the front is holding a 16 megapixels camera. Now as far as the cameras at the back are concerned, the main camera here is a 48 megapixels shooter. The remaining details of this camera sensor will be on your screen. After that, we get an 8 megapixels ultra wide camera. And then we have a 2 megapixels depth camera and a 2 megapixels dedicated macro shooter. Next to the LED flash, we have some camera details. For example, it says AI quad camera and 48 megapixels 1:1.8x25 ASH. I don't know what this exactly means, but we will definitely know about this In our detailed review of the Huawei Nova 7i, the Nova 7i weighs at about 188 grams and this is a pretty heavy phone. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and set this phone up. I will see you on the other side. Setting this phone up is not going to be your typical Android setup experience. What I mean is this phone comes without the Google Play services and the Google Play Store. So it's not going to ask you for your Google account while you configure it for the very first time. What this phone is going to do is, it's going to ask you to sign up for a new Huawei ID or use your existing Huawei ID. You can sign up for the Huawei ID by using your email address or your phone number. Now this Huawei ID is going to be the most important part when it comes to using the HMS. In case you don't know, HMS is the Huawei mobile system which replaces the GMS on the Huawei phones. So this is going to work in line with the Huawei's app gallery, which is ultimately going to allow you to install all of your favorite Android applications on the Huawei Nova 7i. Alright, so now it's asking me to set up my fingerprint scanner on the phone. It's a good chance to check out the performance of its side-mounted fingerprint scanner, so I am just going to register it. It's asking me to set up the face recognition as well, so I'll just do that too right now. Okay guys, now that the phone is almost set up, we can see that it's asking me to install some of these popular applications, but I don't really need any of these applications, so I am just going to deselect all these. Alright, so our Huawei Nova 7i is fully set up now, and first things first, as I mentioned, this phone comes without any Google services. So how exactly are you going to install the applications? Now Huawei has given us the app gallery, and in the app gallery, Huawei has put in a lot of efforts to bring all popular applications and also bring all the popular app developers on its platform. Huawei has invested billions of dollars on its app gallery platform, and it has also worked with some of the local developers in efforts to make this a better platform for the applications. Now, as I open the app gallery, it's asking me to install the most popular applications once again. But I don't really need these applications, so I am not going to install them. Now, the only way you are going to install applications on your phone is by coming into the app gallery. So I want to install the AIDA64 application, which I use to check out the internals of a device. Now, as I searched for this application in the Huawei app gallery, it's already appearing here in the tools category. I will just click on the install button. And the AIDA application has been installed on my Huawei Nova 7i from Huawei's app gallery. Now most of the applications that you usually use in your daily routine, including the WhatsApp, Snapchat, and all other such communication and social media applications, will be easily available in the Huawei app gallery. It's going to be a very rare thing if you are unable to find any application here. However, all the popular Android games and applications will appear in the app gallery, and you can install them without any hassle. So here, first of all, I would like to show you the internals of this phone. Now the Huawei Nova 7i is powered by the high silicon Kirin 810 7 nanometer chipset. It's got the Mali G52 MP6 GPU, and this phone has a RAM of 8 GB. Now this phone also has internal storage of 1 to 8 GB, but I would like to check how much storage is actually available. Now here we can see that right out of the box, about 113 or 114 gigabyte of internal storage is available, which means that the software on this phone has consumed over 14 gigabyte of internal storage. Now the EMUI version of this phone is 10.0.1 and the Android version is Android 10. But once again, bear in mind that this Android comes without anything called Google. I would also like to show you what camera sensor we are getting here on the Huawei Nova 7i. And it turns out Huawei is using its in-house sensor because it's not specified here. So at the back, the main 48 megapixel is going to produce the real 48 megapixel images. Let's quickly check out the camera application of the Huawei Nova 7i. In the camera application, we get the AR lens, the night mode, the portrait mode, the photo mode is there, the video mode is there, and in the more options, we get the pro mode, the slow-mo, panorama, aperture, light painting, and some other options including the super macro mode. If we go into the pro mode of this phone, we can change the focus of the phone. We can also change the ISO, the shutter speed is changeable. We have the exposure value, the autofocus can be turned on or off, and we have the white balance as well. In this phone, we also get the pro video mode, which is a really good addition. Now, if we go into the settings of the camera application while being in the photo mode, from here we can turn on the 48 megapixels mode by switching the resolution to AI Ultra Clarity or the 4:3, which is the standard 48 megapixels mode. In the normal photo mode, the phone is going to stick to the 12 megapixels. As far as the battery capacity of the Huawei Nova 7i is concerned, this phone has a 4200 milliamp battery, which can be charged using the 40 watt super fast charger. Now guys, I would like to remind you that I have a really big battery drain test coming on my channel, in which I'll be comparing the Galaxy A71, A31, the Mi Note 10 Lite, and all the Redmi Note 9 series smartphones. So make sure that you hit the subscribe button to not to miss that upcoming video. And now I have the Galaxy A51 next to the Huawei Nova 7i, and obviously the Galaxy A51 is a lighter and a thinner phone. The A51 feels more grippable in the hand and more premium as well. And now here is the Redmi Note 9S next to the Huawei Nova 7i, and I can tell you right now that despite being a heavier and a bigger phone, the Redmi Note 9S feels like a more premium choice. Obviously, I'll be comparing the cameras of these phones. In fact, I'll be doing the detailed camera comparison between the Galaxy A51 and the Nova 7i as well. There are so many videos coming out on my channel, and I would want you guys to keep an eye on all the upcoming videos. If you like this video, please make sure to hit the like button, and if you loved it, do hit the red subscribe button as well. With that said, I will sign off, and I will see you in the next one really soon.